Guys, I'm Stephen Lowe, and today we're going over why you should not do scapular retraction at the beginning of pull-ups and what normal scapulohumeral rhythm is. So normal scapulohumeral rhythm, this relates to a little bit to the shoulder impingement I just put out. But in general, basically the scapula on the back of the shoulder area here and the shoulder joint make up the range of motion to go fully overhead with the shoulder. So as you can see here, going up fully overhead requires the scapula to do some of the movement and the shoulder joint to do some of the movement. And so normal scapulohumeral rhythm is about 60 degrees rotation of the scapula. So it'll rotate up about 60 degrees, and then the shoulder joint itself will rotate up about 120 degrees to get that full overhead 120 degrees of motion. And so why this is important, obviously, to go fully overhead without having some irritation in the shoulder, you need both the scapula and the shoulder joint to have the full range of motion to get overhead. So specifically, I wanted to talk about why retraction in pull-ups is a bad idea to start out. There's actually a lot of fitness people out there saying at the bottom of the pull-up, you want to kind of depress and then retract, which is depression is pulling the scapulas down, and then retract is bringing them together. Depress and retract the scapulas to begin the pull-up. That's incorrect. What you want to do is mainly depress the scapulas and don't retract them. So let me explain why. So in the image on the right of the slide, you can see what happens when you retract the scapula. Basically, when you retract the scapulas and pull them together, the bottom edge of the scapula will pull in towards the spine. So it pulls basically the whole scapula in. If this is the spine, it pulls it all the way into the spine here. And basically, instead of allowing it to freely rotate up like that, so when the scapula upwardly rotates for pull-ups to get fully overhead, the bottom part of the scapula actually needs to rotate away from the spine so that can go fully overhead like that. And so when you're hanging in a pull-up and you're retracting the scapula, as you can see on the top purple arrow, it actually, when you rotate it down like that, it causes the top edge of the scapula to start to push into the shoulder joint like that. As you can see in the top arrow there and the red marked area, it starts to push into that, and that's where it can start to impinge or start to rub on the shoulder capsule or the areas under the acromion. So when that happens, it can actually create some pain and dysfunction there and actually be one of the causes for shoulder impingement. So doing a hard retraction, especially at the beginning of the pull-up when you're hanging, is actually a big risk factor there for pain and injury in pull-ups. And so I'll show you why on the next slide here. So as you can see, when the arm is overhead like that, and you start to retract the scapula towards the spine, it starts to put pain and injury, or pain and rubbing right underneath the scapula there. This is an upright row picture, but as you can see with the upright row, and the arm overhead, similar motion as the arm overhead here. Retracting that scapula and pulling it towards the spine like that is going to rotate the spine or the scapula like this. And so it's going to downward rotate it like this, and you have more risk of impingement and rubbing up the structures there. So upright rows, the behind the neck pull-ups and push-ups, and then overhead, especially with the scapular retraction at the beginning, you don't want to do that. Just depress the scapulas, and then as you naturally do the pull-up, the scapulas will rotate and retract at the end of the movement, but you don't want to do it initially since it can cause that potential risk factor and rubbing of the structures underneath the acromion and increase your risk for shoulder impingement.